Did you ever see that really old cartoon where at one point in time it was like a Jew dressed as a wolf?
Oh, what was that? Like a Nazi?
Or a wolf dressed as a Jew? No, it was like fucking like an old Mickey Mouse cartoon.
Yeah, I don't know if I've seen this one. I can't remember.
This is, there was some. Look at this.
Oh, yeah. Wow.
It's a wolf dressed as a Jew. Look at this. So, no, it wasn't a wolf. Yeah, see, there it is. So
he's it was the wolf pretending to be a Jew.
Yes.
Oh, I took that all the wrong way at first. I thought it was a Jew pretending to be a wolf.
No.
Now I get it.
A wolf with a Jew mask on. But how crazy is that?
And this is 1933.
Yeah. How wild is that?
Yeah, it is. It is pretty wild.
Three Little Pigs, 1933, the Jew peddler scene. Now, didn't they change it in the future? I think in the future, they redid it, and they turned it into just a wolf. Yeah, so this is the one on the right, see? The cleaned up version. They stopped having it be a Jew.
Okay,
it
had
to
be a wolf
pretending to be a person.
That was the first iteration of wokeness, was they were like, yeah, we can't really get away with that Jew thing anymore.
Isn't that wild?
It is pretty wild. You know what's wild about like that time when you see like the propaganda that was for adults? Clearly at that time, but it would be cartoons. Have you ever seen the one? There's the one where it's Daffy Duck. Is it Daffy Duck? Or wait, I'm confusing the two ducks. It's one of those ducks, but it's a whole like pay your taxes
thing. Is it Donald?
Yes, Donald Duck. Yeah. Sorry, I always get those confused. And I got little kids. I should be better.
And then there's the one duck that's like really rich. Who's the one?
That
duck?
Was Scrooge McDuck.
Yeah, Scrooge McDuck. Yes. Uncle Scrooge.
That's right. Yeah, he was his uncle, right? But do you ever see the one I'm talking about? Where it's like pay your taxes.
I do believe
it's this
see,
one.
Yes, let me see that. Disney War propaganda. Donald Duck versus taxes. Here it goes. Wow. 1943.
Yes, payday. Millions of dollars pouring into the hands of the American worker. Now in the mind of the average worker live two separate personalities. One, the thrifty.
Scrooge.
Wait a bit, laddie. You're going to save a bit of that, aren't you?
Oh, yeah. Sure.
Oftentimes, idle money burns a hole in your pocket, which brings out the other personality. The spendthrift.
Look at this, he's a pimp.
All right, big shot. Come on with me. I'll show you how to spend your dough.
Oh boy, oh boy, oh boy!
I got a couple of good dates.
Hello.
But laddie, I've got some better dates.
Important ones, too, when every American should pay his or her income tax gladly and proudly. This year, thanks to Hitler and Hirohito, taxes are higher than ever before. Will you have enough money on hand to meet your payments when they fall due?
We'll take care of that later.
All right.
Forget it. Keep watching.
But you don't want to forget our fighting men, do you?
Yes, sir.
Then you'll have to start saving right away to meet your tax payments.
Listen,
child.
Spend it.
Yeah, it goes on, I think, for a while. But isn't it like, is it crazy this is for grown-ups?
Yeah.
You must save for victory.
What's money for? Spend it. Shoot the works.
Nay.
Wow.
Save it. Spend.
He's trying to get him to the Idle Hour Club. Oh, look, it's a Nazi swastika.
You see? And that's what happens when you don't give your taxes.
You go through the Idle Hour Club. It's a swastika for a front door.
No, well, you didn't pay your taxes. Support your boys.
Look, he's got swastikas in his eyes.
They made him look like Hitler.
Oh, my God. They gave him a Hitler mustache.
And a little swoop.
And a swastika for a tie. Oh, my God. This is crazy. Well, you know, it was pretty easy to distribute propaganda back then.
Yeah, you could make cartoons for grown-ups, and that would convince them.
Look what they did with Reefer Madness.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
Reefer Madness in, what is it, the 30s when they put that out?
I think so, yeah.
That fucked people up for 100 years.
I know. It's amazing that it says something about how different our culture is, though, that like that type of propaganda would work back then and how much more sophisticated it has to be today. You know, like it was like a simpler time.
Well, now it's a comedy.
Yeah.
If you watch Reefer Madness now, it's a comedy. Like a thing that was meant to terrify you is now unintentionally hilarious.
Yeah, and just imagine like if Say, like, you took someone from the 1930s and just showed them, like, an action movie today, like a high-def action movie, they'd be like, what in the world is this? Like, they would just blow their minds. You know what I mean?
Fast and the Furious 15 or whatever it is.
Or you, like, they're used to a movie where it's like, see, now, yeah, we got a dame coming. And then, like, you just showed them this. It'd be like,
isn't it also interesting that we accepted a certain very specific way of talking that is completely unnatural for a narrator to be explaining what is happening to Donald Duck?
Yeah.
It's like a weird fucking DJ voice thing.
I was watching recently with my daughter the original Frosty the Snowman movie, and the movie just opens with some guy, you know, is just like, it was the first snow of the season, and all Frosty would come up, you know what I mean? And it's just such a, I just found it kind of great, because I was like, this is just such a lost, like, thing. Mm-hmm. I'm kind of glad she's seeing this, you know what I mean? Because it's just such a different time. And a different, you know what I mean? Like a different voice, and like it's very strange. It's kind of cool in a way. I'm interested in that time period. Well, I mean, not so much the pay your tax propaganda. No. That part I don't like.
But Frosty the Snowman.
But Frosty is Frosty was cool.
Yeah,
that guy was all right.
The Freeze Meister.
Yeah,
remember that dude?
I'm thinking, how would you have seen this in 1943 when it came out? Like,
probably the movie theaters?
Like before something? Like, it just played a bunch of shit? Like,
I'd imagine it'd be theaters.
They would play the news in movie theaters. So you'd go to the movie theater and they would show you what is going on in World War II, Allied troops. They would show you footage.
But you talk about how easy it would be to just capture the narrative completely back then. Like it was
false flags. They're so easy to pull off.
Yep.
Look at the Gulf of Tonkin.
Uh-huh.
They're so easy to pull off.
Yeah, they would get away with a lot of that stuff.